What do you think about when you think about volcanoes? Do you think about explosive eruptions or slow lava flows? There is a lot more to know about volcanoes and volcanic eruptions. First, let's talk about what a volcano is. A volcano is defined as a fissure that develops in the Earth's crust as magma moves forcefully towards the Earth's surface. Volcanoes are constructed as magma accumulates around the fissure opening. Volcanoes are normally classified into shields, cinder cones, and stratovolcanoes. Shield volcanoes are large, broad, domed structures formed by layers of lava that quietly flow out of the vent and accumulate over time. Mauna Loa in Hawaii is a good example. A second type is smaller and called a cinder cone. These are made of a volcanic rock called scoria, which are small bits of lava ejected by volcanic gases that hardened in midair. Because scoria is never thrown very far from the vent, cinder cones are steep. The most beautiful volcanoes are large, steep stratovolcanoes. These are composite volcanoes that are formed out of alternating layers of scoria-like pyroclastic material and lava. These constructions are steep and strong and reach great heights. Fujiyama in Japan is a famous example. These are the three types of volcanoes that you may be familiar with, but did you know that most volcanoes erupt deep under the sea? These deep-sea volcanoes can't easily be classified as shields, cinder cones, or stratovolcanoes. So what are they? This is a map of the world's ocean ridge system that spans more than 70,000 kilometers in total. These spreading ridges are located at divergent margins and are defined as a nearly continuous range of underwater volcanic mountains. The Mid-Atlantic Ridge is arguably the most famous example of a spreading ocean ridge. These ridges are essentially one long volcano that is neither shield, composite, or cinder cone. Because volcanic eruptions underwater are not explosive, they generally create a different kind of lava, known as pillow lava. Pillow lavas are distinctly tube-shaped and are indicative of a submarine volcanic eruption. The volcanic processes found at mid-ocean ridges and the way that these volcanoes form are different than any of the three traditional types of volcanoes. What do you think we should call these submarine volcanoes? As you can see, there is still much to learn about them, especially those hidden deep in the ocean.